All right, Mr. Sotko here, and welcome back to another Company Heroes 2 replay cast. And before I get started, I'd like to just say, if you like these replays, check out COH2.org. That's where I get all these replays, and there's plenty of casters on there, and plenty of replays just like this one, so check it out if you get a chance. And today's a 2v2 on rails and metal, and the fuel points, relatively easy to capture for each side. And over on the north side, we have two Russian players. The blue is Rustam. And up here we have Source Allure, and I believe that's what you call the Witcher in the non-English books. And at the bottom we have two OKW, the pink is Sir Alexander, and red being Slurm McKenzie. And three engineers for the Blue Russian, a little bit strange, but they get out, they do create very fast, so they can get out really quickly, capture a lot of stuff. And I really enjoy this map. I think it's a lot of fun. It's really open, yet it has all kinds of things to hide behind and give you a lot of cover. The munitions are directly in the center, and the victory points are directly across the center as such. Now we have a Kubel wagon moving up, looking to get in a position to suppress some troops. But they're moving around it, and they might miss these. These might actually might be able to flank here. Just going to have to pull that Kubel wagon out. And Red has a Kubel wagon of their own just coming out now. The Kubel wagon looks like it's a little bit of trouble here. These conscripts are going to get some pretty good damage on it. Going to have to back that out of there, but the Sturmfighters are right up here doing huge close-range damage and moving the conscripts back now. Engineers moving forward, going to take this far right victory point, the very first victory point of the game. Meanwhile, the red OKW player taking munitions point, and the northern fuel point being taken by engineers. Conscripts moving into the trench here, getting some good cover, and they can actually take it from this trench because it does... The munitions circle does enter that trench, but he moves them out, and I think he should have kept them there. He had really good cover there. And now these conscripts are getting suppressed by this Kubel wagon while it's being repaired, and now they are completely pinned, so they're going to have to get out of there. And here come some engineers, and they're going to want to take this good cover here, so they don't get suppressed as easily, but there's a lot of firepower coming in from the OKW. Volksgrenadiers and Sturmpioneers moving in on them, and still some engineers in this building here provide a little bit of long-range cover. The red OKW player moving up, pushed the Russian player out of the way, and going to take this fuel point for their own now. However, the fuel point on the bottom still contested, but looks like it's going to be an OKW hands pretty soon. And Kubel wagon still laying down fire, still suppressing troops. And in the middle of the other Kubel wagon is moving over. Going to try and get another flank on the troops over here. And chasing these engineers down, three squads of engineers. Actually, four squads of engineers now. And the reason of that is he has three T-35 mine cost reduction intel bulletins. So he's going to be putting a lot of mines all over the place, for sure. And this Kubel wagon is just tearing things up, just shooting at these all these troops. No one's really shooting back. And now we have some troops over here in good cover. Shoot at that Kubel wagon. This Kubel wagon is still alive. And we have a clown car, the light scout car for the Russians, and the scout car actually beats a Kubel wagon pretty much any day. And this wreckage, which actually salvaged earlier by the OKW, it's just a world wreckage, but it can still be salvaged by OKW players. Gives them a little bit of free gas, and I think munitions as well. Now the OKW all the way up to the Russian base here, taking this last territory point. First for the Russians, last for the OKW. Storm Pioneers getting in a pickle here. And now that they're a little far from these engineers here, they're going to do some pretty good damage. They can just start firing on these engineers, and they're going to do huge damage to these engineers, even though they have a little bit of cover. Down to one engineer, but now retreating the Stern Pioneers out of there. We have a Raketenwerfer over here, and it is cloaked at the moment in some high grass. I think it's just a little bit of high grass right there. And the Russians contesting this territory point, five conscripts on four Volksgrenadiers, so it's going to be a pretty good fight. And I think the Volksgrenadiers are going to lose this just because the conscripts have the light cover there. Now the Russian player has a sniper out, the superior Russian sniper, because there are two snipers. So if you lose one, you don't instantly lose your sniper, you can actually just retreat back and get the second. A Raketenwerfer back here, but not really too useful right now because there's nothing out for the for the Russian. They do have that scout car, but it is all the way up here, and that's what he brought it out for, but not going to be able to get it because it's just moving across the map over that way. So moving back some stuff here. Still has the territory point, but the fuel point is falling back into Russian hands. But they do have, the OKW do have the northern fuel point. So it's going to even it out a little bit. These Volksgrenadiers have a Panzerschreck and are going to hit this scout car, but also going to take a whole bunch of damage from the scout car's machine gun and the flamethrower. So they have to retreat out of there. Wasn't able to get the Panzerschreck fire off. And they would have only been able to hit it probably just once, which wouldn't destroy it anyway, but would do some pretty good damage to it. Tons of engineers here now fighting back. The blue Russian player with four squads of engineers. A little crazy, but whatever works. And these engineers are in cover, but the Volksgrenadiers are superior troops and going to be chasing these away sooner or later here. Jaeger Light Infantry is chasing away the sniper. Almost got it, but retreated just in time. The Russian player has a forward HQ here, and this is one of my favorite strategies, is forward HQ. I love forward HQ. For anybody that doesn't know what forward HQ is, you can reinforce here. It provides six medics, and it gives you an attack and defensive buff to all the troops within a small radius around it, so it's really, really good. However, OKW have a way to counter these. If you get the walking Stuka and then hit this building with a walking Stuka, it will destroy this building and will take away the forward HQ for the Russian player. Sturm Pioneer is taking the middle munitions point, and they already have the other munitions point, so they're going to have quite a bit of munitions coming in pretty soon here. And as long as they convert the munitions to fuel, they'll have quite a bit because that's all that munitions being converted. Sturm Officer and Volksgrenadiers in a battle against some guards rifle and a clown car. Gonna have to run out of there. Not gonna be able to handle that. Conscripts running away from Sturm Pioneers. Got a couple kills as they were running by there. So not too bad. However, there is a scout car raining some havoc down on these Sturm Pioneers. They're gonna have to run out of there. Don't want to lose too many of them. Sturm Pioneers are actually pretty expensive to replace. They're about, I believe it's 40 munitions, which is quite a bit to replace any individual Sturm Pioneer. But if you use them properly, you can get lots of kills. You can definitely get your money's worth out of them. Panzer Fusiliers over here in the trench in preparation for these guards rifle infantry. They're going to move up on them sooner or later. The Russians totally controlling the right side here. Now I have a 45mm anti-tank gun, and these are just a little anti-tank gun, so these are kind of fun to use. They're typically only good against Kubel wagons, light vehicles, maybe a Puma at best. But anything like a Panzer IV or V, they just pretty much ping off, and it would take a good amount of them to take out a Panzer, unless you're hitting him in the rear armor. Clown car, I'm now moving into the battle down here. Notices what's going on, gonna move down here. However, they do have Panzerschreck, so it's not really gonna be able to do too much. It's just gonna immediately get hit by a Panzerschreck and do really good damage. Might even take out the engine. Over in the top side, the red OKW player fighting the yellow Russian player. And there is a sniper here gathering up some kills. Only 10 kills on that sniper. And there is some dynamite here, and they're going to walk right over that dynamite. And he detonates it, loses almost all those troops. That was kind of amazing. And the blue Russian player with his mass engineer still here in the trench and fighting it out with these Jaeger Light Infantry and Volksgrenadiers. But they only have flamethrowers, so it's very, very short range. So one of these engineers has a flamethrower in every group, and that provides actually a little bit of less firepower because this is not actually shooting at long range. However, it does prevent the OKW player from getting to this flag point. Sturm Officer taking the northern fuel point. But the Russians still have the southern fuel point, so just going to even it out there. Guards rifle and conscripts up at the top. Might be moving towards this victory point here. Probably can pick that up pretty easy, except for the fact that there is a Schwerer Panzer headquarters, and that's going to prevent any troops from coming in that region. Volksgrenadiers firing back at these engineers in the trench, but they have such great cover in the trench that they're just really not losing any troops here. And he might actually lose his Volksgrenadiers to engineers, just because he can't really hit them in that trench. We have a Panzer II out on the field. However, there are Guards Rifle. There is a couple squads of Guards Rifle, and they do pretty good damage to a light vehicle such as the Panzer II. So it's going to have to watch out for that. The Raketenwerfer is still all the way in the back here, waiting for any clown cars to come along. Volksgrenadiers with the Panzerschrecks hiding behind this good cover of the tractor there. And now getting a defilade shot on that enfilade. I can never remember the difference. But firing right into that trench right in front of them, and able to get past that cover there. 45mm anti-tank gun moving up, and there are some Pinot Battalions here, and Pinot Battalions are actually pretty good. They have semi-automatic rifles, and they typically beat out Volksgrenadiers or regular Grenadier squads when they're one-on-one like that. And you can put lots of flamethrowers on them, so I've seen many replays where people just pretty much mass Pinot Battalions, and they have four or five flamethrowers on the group of them. So it's a pretty wild combination to have all that flame. Panzer II has been repaired and is moving out now, and the scout car is here, and scout car is going to take a big beating from this Panzer II. Going to have to get out of there. And the Panzer II fires in, I think, five or six volley shots. So trying to move it out of there, but he's going to move right into the 76mm machine anti-tank gun and takes one hit from it. May take another hit, but just barely gets out of the range, it looks like. And the engine has been taken out by these conscript squads. Looks like they may have pinned it and destroyed the Panzer II, but didn't destroy it completely. It is just now abandoned, so they might be able to take that back and use it as their own now. Ready for action. And they do. They do take the Panzer II and is now moving it back and going to repair that up, use that as their own. Panzer II is a very good vehicle against troops. And Jaeger Light Infantry and Volksgrenadiers now taking the southern fuel point, and the Russians really need to take this back, because if they lose out on the fuel point and give it all to the OKW, the OKW is going to be very powerful very soon. A Walking Stuka is out, and the Walking Stuka looks like it did destroy this, as I said earlier, that is a very, very easy counter. The Ford HQ will go down to one barrage of a Stuka. Just about any building will go down. And so it's a very good way to counter Ford HQ. So make sure you guys remember that. Panzer Fusilier is fighting it out with some snipers here. These snipers are in negative cover. So if these Panzer Fusiliers just moved up a little bit, they might be able to actually get these. They're going to take extra damage. And moving that one sniper away. And now retreating it for a little extra speed to get out of there. Battlegroup headquarters set up right over here. So now all the troops have to do is just move right over there. And with this Schwerer Panzer headquarters, it's going to be very difficult to take this victory point. It looks like the range, you might be able to just stand right here, but I'm sure the Russians don't know that. And Panzer II now fighting it out with these Panzer Fusiliers, and the Panzer Fusiliers have no answer to that Panzer II. They're going to have to get out of there. Just going to lose a couple men in the process. Engineers and Pinot Battalions moving in with flamethrowers. Going to try and burn out this Sturm officer here. And if you actually kill the Sturm officer out of the group, all troops surrounding that officer will automatically retreat back to base. So it can be a blessing to have the Sturm officer, but it also can be bad luck in disguise. If it actually gets killed, all your troops will retreat. Sturm Pioneers going to battle it out with this Panzer II here, but not going to do anything to it. And going to make them run away in a quick hurry. And they need to take that back as soon as possible. And they also need to take this field point here, but the Russians just aren't able to take it. There's too many Volksgrenadiers, Sturm Officer, that are giving all those a buff, as well as the Jaeger Light Infantry. We have some Sturm Pioneers salvaging this object here. Looks like it may have been a scout car at one point. Just a burning wreckage now. And I think you get like 5 fuel for doing that, so it definitely adds up over time, and you might as well. Score so far, the OKW at 462 and the Russians at 439, so very close game actually. And nobody has the center victory point right now, so you can just easily send an engineer squad or something over here to take that and start reducing the OKW score down. Panzer Fusiliers and Volksgrenadiers now moving to the victory point, going to take this victory point. And that will leave the OKW with 2 victory points and will reduce the Russians' points very slowly. Sniper moving back in, and the Panzer II just sitting around, just waiting for something to engage. Guards rifle infantry also moving towards the center. It looks like they're just going to stay there, wait for anything to come along. I think they should send a little extra troops over here, because right now this is pretty much the battle zone. And we have a T-70, just took, like, looks like it took 2 Panzer Shreks at the same time, almost destroyed that. And here comes the Panzer II to force away these Panzer Shreks, but they're going to turn around and start battling back. But they will lose a few men in the process. 3-star engineers here. The problem with 3-star engineers, it really doesn't give that much of a bonus to engineers. So that's why you really want to put flamethrowers on Pinot Battalions, because the Pinot Battalions, with every star, they do get a lot better than engineers do. from conscripts against this Stern Pioneer squad, but looks like they got temporarily suppressed by the Schwerer Panzer headquarters. Looks like an incendiary artillery barrage hit in this area, so it's going to stop any troops from going through here, but tanks, they don't mind the fire. They're going to move right through it. And there is a Raketenwerfer, and he's trying to turn it around and trying to get a hit on this T-70, but T-70s are very quick. But he turned it around ahead in advance, and now it looks like he may lose this T-70 because of that. If he can just get hit by one Panzer Shrek, there it goes, and loses that. A pretty big, fairly big loss for the Russian team. Although a T-70 only costs 70 fuel, so not too big of a loss, but definitely don't want to lose it if you don't have to. And here comes some penal battalions, and they do have a 45mm anti-tank gun all the way in the back here, but there's really just nothing to use it against. An incoming Jagdpanzer for the OKW. They're going to bring that up, and if the Panzer II shows its face around that Jagdpanzer, it will definitely take a big, big hit. And two penal battalions moving in with flamethrowers here. However, we have a walking Stuka barrage that's going to come somewhere around here, going to land and take some things out. Almost takes out an entire engineer squad, and almost did a pretty good amount of damage to the Panzer II, but just barely missed the missiles. Penal battalions burning out the Jaeger light infantry, and the Sturm Pioneer, Sturm officer behind him, may soon follow. As long as he just moves up, he needs to move up just a little bit and get some fire on that Sturm officer. However, all the troops are just running right over here, and then they can run back very quickly. So what the Russians need to do is go over here and get rid of this battlegroup headquarters. Penal battalions can throw a satchel charge, which does a lot of damage. It takes exactly 3 satchel charges to destroy one of these headquarters, like so. And Panzer II chasing the walking Stuka, and the walking Stuka driving away for its life. It was getting hit in the back, now it's getting hit in the frontal armor, so it's not taking as much damage, but he will lose that. And he may lose the Panzer II as well, because here incoming Panzer Shreks and the Raketenwerfer destroys the Panzer II. However, he didn't buy that Panzer II, so he got quite a bit of his money out of it. All he had to do was steal it and repair it. Conscripts and engineers versus Sturm Pioneers. And you can just see the power of Sturm Pioneers as they take out troops, even though that they're completely outnumbered. So Sturm Pioneers are just so, so good in close range. Incoming Jagdpanzer versus a SU-85, so it's a pretty fair trade here. Four-star Volksgrenadiers moving in on these Pino battalions with flamethrowers. It's going to be hard to take this with flamethrowers with good cover like that. And incoming engineers with flamethrowers as well, so a whole bunch of flame going on over there. Jagdpanzer looks like it took a couple hits there from some rockets and moves back. Was a precision bombing strike. Did a little bit of damage there. Did more so damage to the battlegroup headquarters. Now, if he can just get some penal battalions over there, throw a couple satchel charges, that will be gone. It will set the OKW back. And then he will have to retreat all the way back to his base until he builds another one. Red OKW player taking all of the top at the same time here. So that's going to be a big blow to the Russians, taking all this from them. Score so far, OKW 430 and the Russians 401. So Russians slightly losing, but it's still anybody's game at this moment. Penal battalions moving in. And they do have a flamethrower, so all of his penal battalions and all of his engineers have flamethrowers, so he's just a flame madness here. And he has two 45mm anti-tank guns, and here comes a T-70 versus a Jagdpanzer, but the T-70 isn't going to win that directly. He's going to have to get behind this Jagdpanzer, and he's almost got it. However, there's just way too much OKW forces. There's a Raketenwerfer and Panzer Shreks all over the place, and if he gets in front of that Jagdpanzer, he's going to take a big, big hit. An incoming 2cm flak emplacement, so he's just taking way too much damage on this T-34. I don't think he's going to make it and loses the T-34. Big loss to the Russians. Another vehicle has been lost in the defense of the Rodina. The Russians do have two 45mm anti-tank guns over here, but they are actually very, very weak to most tanks. SU-85 up here with a 76mm gun. And the guard's rifle chasing away the Sturm Pioneers. And the two Volksgrenadier squads, Panzer Shreks, Jaeger Light Infantry, moving forward and brought up the 45mm anti-tank gun. I'm not sure why. He's not going to really be able to do anything, especially if he hits his Jagdpanzer right in the front. The Jagdpanzer has quite a bit of frontal armor, and it's just not going to do anything. The 45 just simply isn't. If you brought that 76mm Yellow is 76 millimeter. That would be a much better bet to do some damage to this Jagdpanzer. Looks like an incendiary barrage is going to be coming down on some of these troops, but they move out of the way, and the only thing that actually got hit by it was the Raketenwerfer, and it is down to two men. Up top, the Russians attempt them to take back the top here, but they don't really have too many troops up. And Sturm Officer and Obersoldaten moving in on these Guard Rifle infantry, and these Guard Rifles going to lose out on that fight because the Sturm Officer giving a buff to the Obersoldaten. Conscripts need to move up, maybe get behind this tree, get a little bit of cover. Down here, Jaeger Light Infantry moving in, flanking out these Pino Battalions, throwing grenades on these Pino Battalions. Doesn't move those, he might lose that whole squad, loses a whole squad of Pino Battalions with a flamethrower.
The sector is at risk.
And still needs to take out this battlegroup headquarters. It has been repaired back up, so lost his opportunity to take that out. With ease, that is. And Volksgrenadiers, 4-star Volksgrenadiers, under fire. And there's no pun intended there. They are definitely under fire. And burning out, lost a troop there. Sturmpiners right up in these Pino Battalions' face. These Pino Battalions are going to go down very, very quickly. You can see how fast their health goes down when Sturmpiners start firing. And going to go ahead and retreat those out immediately. OKW nearly at the victory point, but not taking it. They should be just moving a little troops. Probably not paying attention, but if they just moved a troop right onto that, they could take that. The Russian sniper, now a 2-star veteran sniper with 20 kills. Not too bad. Not the most I've ever seen. But definitely worth it as of yet. I mean, a 2-star and 20 kills for what do they cost? 360 manpower, so not too bad. Definitely caused more damage than they costed, so very good. OKW now taking over this trench and taking back the southern fuel point. However, at the same time, Russians taking back the northern fuel point, so sort of negating each other. Guards rifle against Obersoldaten and the Sturm Officer, but both are running away now. And they're simply just going to run back to the battlegroup headquarters and then move back out, so that is the advantage of the OKW, is that they can just put a battlegroup headquarters way up front. And then they can just simply retreat back to it, but it does cost them quite a bit of money to be able to do that. And the downfall is if they lose these, it sort of sets the OKW back quite a bit. Two flamethrower squads burning out these Obersoldaten, and the T-34 doing a really good job of body blocking those Obersoldaten so that they took a couple extra flames, losing the entire squad because of it. T-34 getting hit in the back by a Raketenwerfer, and the Jagdpanzer also firing at it, so he's definitely going to want to get out of there. These Obersoldaten can Panzerfaust, so if they Panzerfaust this and lose its engine, he'll be in a world of hurt. Now going to face his rear armor towards this Schwerer Panzer headquarters, so he's going to take a couple big hits from that, losing a little bit more health. Now the OKW actually moving out of the trench and moving towards the victory point, and forcing away the AT, the two 45mm AT guns, and Conscripts moving in to try and contest this, but not going to be able to do anything against three squads there. And now moving in with a little bit more Conscripts and Pino Battalions with flamethrowers, but I still don't think it's going to be enough. SU-85 firing at the Jagdpanzer here, so they're exchanging fire, and we'll see who wins out this. SU-85 at half health, and the Jagdpanzer just about at half health, a little bit more I would say. Sturmpiners, triple veteran, see Sturmpiners fighting out against two guard squads. It looks like the Russians will take that center victory point. Here comes some Pino Battalions with flamethrowers, but still just not enough against these three. Just keeps bringing one at a time, and that's just not going to be enough. Now brings a second one, trying to flank around the side, but this is a 5-star Volksgrenadier, so it's going to be hard to do a lot of damage there. Should be focusing fire on these Volksgrenadiers here, and loses the majority of his Pino Battalions to a grenade volley there. And we have a detonated point. We have a sabotaged point here with the urban defense tactics. Booby-trap territory, so if any troops run in here, they lose quite a bit of troops. Guards rifle against Obersoldaten, and Conscripts here. 3-star Conscripts against 2-star Obersoldaten, so they might be able to actually beat those out. Now forcing the Obersoldaten to run away, and the guard squad should move up here immediately to attack those two Obersoldaten. OKW retaking this trench here for safety. And we have a 3-star Pino Battalion trying to burn them out, but they have really good cover, so just not taking as much damage as the Russian wants them to. And it looks like we have some incoming Katyusha rockets and hitting the Schwerer Bandrick headquarters, but not going to take it out. Needs to be a lot closer so that those rockets hit in a more centralized area. But it looks like Incendiary Barrage also coming down on this, and it might hit all three of these buildings, so it's going to do some damage to all three of these buildings. But it wasn't an Incendiary Barrage, it was just a precision bombing strike, that is. So it just threw bombs on all three of the, or two of these, and now repairing up his Schwerer Panzer headquarters. Sturm Pioneers and Jaeger Light Infantry in the south, moving his Jaeger Light Infantry back so that he can capture the victory point. Bringing up his SU-85, and it looks like he was trying to bring it up to attack this Schwerer Panzer headquarters, but decided to bring it back a little bit. Didn't know what's in front of him. Can't really see what's in front of him, so didn't want to run into anything that would destroy his tank there. That would be a big loss. Losing tanks in a 1v1 or 2v2 is a big loss, and very hard to recover from. Jagdpanzer is camouflaging itself, and the ZIS-76. Picking pop shots at these Jaeger Light Infantry, but I think they'll be just fine. Here comes some Pedo Battalions to contest the right side munitions point. And he did bring the Katusha up a little bit closer, so as soon as this barrage is ready, being a little bit closer actually decreases the radius of the barrage, so more missiles hit where you want them to. And slowly moving with the Jagdpanzer, now moving it over to the right side. And two squads of engineers with flamethrowers now trying to burn out these Volksgrenadiers and doing quite a bit of damage to them. But now there's grenades all over the place. Going to lose a bunch of these engineers. Actually, only one each. Not too bad. Back in the center, looks like these conscripts and guard squads going to retake this victory point in the center. Score so far, OKW at 373. Russians at 344. So still a very close game. Just the entire time. T-34 all the way in the back. Doesn't really have much to do at the moment. Bringing another T-34 forward. Should bring this one too. Needs to get it repaired. He has two engineers near here, so he can bring these two engineers and just power repair that T-34 there. And T-34 attempted to move into this location here, but there is much to defend it with. Two Volksgrenadiers with a Panzerschreck. And now we have a Jagdtiger moving in. One of the best vehicles in the game. Has the most frontal armor in the game, and of the war for that matter, but only a few were actually built in real life. And turns out they were actually really bad. The chassis would break on them all the time, and it was very inaccurate if you moved it, because you'd have to recalibrate. And you can view that online, you can just look these up, and turns out they weren't actually that good in combat, just because they would break down a lot. SU-85 moving back, and engineers in this house here with good cover, but not really going to be able to handle a Sturm officer and two Opus for that. OKW just infesting the middle here, taking the middle victory point and the right side munitions point, pushing the Russians back. The Russians are starting to lose out on this battle here, and Pinot Battalion's running away from these five-star Volksgrenadiers. And bringing up his Katusha once more. And looks like his barrage still not ready just yet. Looks like he has about 13 seconds left. And Jagdtiger moving forward. Gonna spot this SU-85. And I think coming around this corner, the SU-85 is gonna get the first hit. However, the Rakettenwerfer hits the SU-85, forcing him to turn around. And he's turning the wrong way. That is not the correct way he wants to be turning. And the Jagdtiger firing at these guard squads point blank. Hate to be in those shoes. Jagdpanzer in the center here. Nothing really to battle against. He has a T-34 here and another T-34 being currently repaired. So he has two T-34s. A little tongue-tied there. But each of them are about half health. And so not really too useful right now. Two SU-85s for the yellow Russian player. However, I don't think it's going to be enough for this Jagdpanzer. He's moving this Jagdpanzer back towards his base. Should just actually be backing up his Jagdpanzer. Just face it this way and just back it up. Sturm Pioneers against these 45mm anti-tank guns, and there's two of them here, and they're going to lose out on these in a quick hurry. There's really no reason that he should have these up. He was trying to hit the Jagdpanzer, but again, the 45mm anti-tank gun is just not that good. Jagdpanzer firing at the T-34. It is in range, and T-34 taking maybe one more hit. 105 howitzer barraging this area, taking out quite a bit of troops. And now the Russians, the OKW rather, own most of the map, and the Russians just own this tiny little portion and what's directly in front of their base. So they are definitely way, way behind on resources right now and need to start taking everything back as soon as they can. They should be coordinating a little bit more their tanks. If the SU-85s move down like this and the T-34s move across too, they might be able to get this Jagd Panzer, might be able to do some damage to the troops too, but there are quite a bit of Panzer Shreks. So that makes it kind of hard to do. Two SU-85s moving on this Jagd Panzer, or Jagd Tiger. The thing about the Jagd Tiger though is when it gets hit in the front, I've noticed, it dazes the crew very, very easily, more than any other tank I've ever seen. See, this SU-85 just got hit in the front and it is not dazed, but when these SU-85 fire, there's a very high chance to daze the crew of the Jagd Tiger. It happens a lot, so that is the big downfall of the Jagd Tiger in this game, other than the fact that it's very slow. Moving the T-34, losing both SU-85s, a big loss for the Yellow Russian. Moving this T-34, trying to get around this Jagd Panzer, going to hit it in the back armor, but just not going to be able to do it because there's just too many. There's a Panzer Shrek here, and all this Jagd Panzer has to do is just back up a little bit. One shot, it's going to finish off that T-34. And losing that T-34, that is just the Russians down to just one tank now. And a Katyusha as vehicles. And he's moving the T-34 in now, just sort of moving right in. Not a good idea. Rustam has left the game, so this is just an AI now. And the AI is trying to back up out of there, but the AI is just a little bit stupid. And taking way too many unnecessary hits here. This Jagd Panzer is going to turn around, get one shot on that T-34, and that T-34 is lost. So the only player remaining now is Source Allure. And I hope I'm saying that right. I just know that that's the name they call the Witcher in the non-English versions. I believe, anyway. It's usually on all the books. Although I haven't read the books myself. Conscripts moving down, trying to take the munitions point. And the ZIS-76 firing, looks like it's pretty much nothing. And the AI is now sort of moving down, trying to get on the offensive. They booby-trap the victory point. And these conscripts here fighting it out with five-star Stern Pioneers. Going to lose these conscripts in a quick hurry to five-star Stern Pioneers. And the ZI-76 is in trouble. Going to want to back that out of there. There's way too much firepower on that ZI-76 to barrage, to be able to barrage those troops. And loses the ZIS-76. So not much left for the Russian team. And Source Allure has surrendered, leaving the OKW as the victors of this game. And I hope you guys enjoyed this replay, and I will see you guys next time.